Well, it's time now for our newest segment, Thrifty Thursdays. It's with Jessica Hacker, who's an extreme couponer, by the way. She'll be joining us every Thursday, teaching us how to feed a family of six for under 10 bucks. Who doesn't love that?
I know. Who doesn't?
Pretty awesome. So what are we making today?
So today is really a big meal. I mean, we're doing a roasted chicken and flatbread, Hasselback potatoes, which there's nothing special about them, but they just look really fun the way they're presented, and roasted vegetables.
All right. So go ahead and get started. And we've got the price list as we go along.
Perfect. Yeah. So, I mean, a whole chicken is really cheap. You can always pick one up for $5 or less. Okay. And the best way to cook them, really, just want to make sure you rinse them inside and out, pat them dry, and coat them with whatever seasoning you have in your pantry, or even do a brine. If you're going to do a brine, just remember it's always like 2/3 water to 1/3 salt.
Okay.
And let it soak. Cook it. If you're going to do in the oven, I like to do kind of a faster version of like turn it up to 450, cook it for about 20 minutes, and then turn it down to 400 and cook it for about another 40, really until the legs start to come off and you know it's done.
Okay.
Then the flatbread is really easy and fun to do. It's really just like a pizza dough. I mean, the most expensive part you're going to have is buying your yeast.
Okay.
So you'll have about 66 cents really in the whole deal. So you'll just use one of these, and you will dissolve it in a cup of warm water with a teaspoon of salt, and then you're going to do 2.5 cups of flour, and you're going to put in 2 tablespoons of olive oil and about a teaspoon of salt. Mix it together, and it's just going to form a dough ball. And then you really, this is kind of the fun part, especially if you have little kids. You're just going to take a chunk and just spread it out. It doesn't need to be pretty. That's what's kind of fun about the flatbread. Put it on a griddle, just like that, and let it cook.
Do you season it at all?
I like to at least let this side get going. Mm-hmm. And then I just made my own butter for it. And it's a lot easier to make your own garlic butter than it is to buy it.
Okay.
And I use a little food processor. Just throw in garlic, again, any other herbs and seasonings you might have in your pantry, with 1/2 cup of butter, which is going to be a stick of butter. And you just puree it up till it's nice and smooth. And it's so much cheaper. Then you only have about 50 cents. Into your butter, as opposed to paying about $3 or more for already seasoned butter.
And we're doing this without coupons. I know, because sometimes it's hard to find coupons for, I mean, you can't, for produce and for meats and stuff like that.
Yeah, so it is.
Pretty cool.
It is. And that's just it. So, you know, when you're couponing for the seasoning stuff, those are things you have cheap already in your house. And that's it, the idea of making a frugal meal is just use what you have on hand. Don't go out and spend a fortune on the ingredients just because it says you need to use basil. If you don't have it, then, you know,
use something else.
Just do something else. So it's easy. After, you just want to make sure that they're, I don't know if I can grab a hold of it. There we go. It'll start to brown.
That looks good. It smells good.
Yes,
by the way.
And they're great. And so just cook it on both sides like that. Then when you take it off, then it's really nice then to take your butter and spread it on there, cut it into cute little triangles, and you've got a great meal.
Okay.
The Hasselback potatoes, they're a lot of fun. They said it's just taking a normal potato and slicing it. I kind of think of it like the blooming onion of potatoes. You just want to slice it in really thin slices, not go all the way through the potato. You want it still to stay connected. Obviously, the thinner you cut them, the quicker it'll cook for you. And then you just drizzle olive oil on it. Again, any kind of seasonings you have. I like to use garlic, salt, and pepper. And throw it in your oven about 350, and it'll take it, really, about 1/2 hour to 1 hour, kind of depending on how thick they are. And then when it's about done, you just put some cheese on it and finish cooking it, and then it's just like everybody has their own little pull apart potato.
And total cost of the meal is like
$8.24.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, so
it's
breaks
like
down
$1.37
a person. Yeah.
Wow. For
then
six
that's
people.
A lot of food. Yeah, for six people.
All right. And as everyone knows, you're an extreme couponer. You were on TLC's Extreme Couponing. Your website, livingonacoupon.com, teaches you all about couponing. I've been to it many times and used the coupons there. So if you want to visit that, but this is without coupons. So
yeah,
we're gonna put that on our IdahoOnYourSide.com. That's our website, or you can look under the GMI tab on that website, or find it on our Facebook page at Good Morning Idaho. Jessica, thank you for being with us every Thursday. We're going to be teaching you how to buy a meal for your family of six under 10.